extent. This will be the biggest single public display of this art that's ever happened in St. Louis. So the Painting for Peace exhibit is going to be at the Convention Center during the week-long National Urban League Convention. It's open to the public and it's going to be curated, so you'll be able to watch videos and see the story of how the art was created. And I would just urge everyone who has an interest to come down and take a look. I don't think you'll regret doing it.
Regions Bank, we are committed to making our customers' banking easier and their lives better.
New Balance St. Louis, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. New Balance St. Louis, locally owned stores in Richmond Heights, Creve Coeur, and Fairview Heights.
There's a super fun city, a quick getaway, where there's so much excitement you need more than a day. St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family, infinity plus a ton. It's got works of wonder, things to wow your brain, an amazing pet performance, all aboard on the train. Some museums are historic, some hit the red blues notes, maybe catch a cards game, whatever paddles your boat. Yeah, St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family, infinity plus a ton.
Welcome to the 135th Annual Veiled Prophet Parade, presented by the VP of St. Louis since 1878. This live broadcast is sponsored by Regions Bank. The 2017 Veiled Prophet Parade theme is Great Things Are Happening, celebrating great music, great talent, and great people from St. Louis, across the country and around the world. Featuring the area's best marching bands, hundreds of costumed characters, giant helium-filled balloons, 17 custom floats, and honorary Grand Marshal Major General John C. Flournoy Jr., U.S. Transcom Chief of Staff. All coming your way next, live from downtown St. Louis, it's the 135th Annual Veiled Prophet Parade.
Town St. Louis, and as you can see, great things are about to happen right here along Market Street in downtown St. Louis for the VP Parade, America's Birthday Parade. And they are lined up, as you can see, 10, 12 deep along the parade route here in downtown St. Louis. A long time tradition here, and we are so excited about the start of your parade. Coming up in just a couple of minutes. We are your hosts this morning. I'm Kent Earhart.
And I am Laura Hediger. And as Kent mentioned, we are coming to you live from downtown St. Louis, the gateway to the west, for the 135th VP Parade.
We do
this
every year in St. Louis, and it just keeps getting bigger and better every year. And you can see behind us the beautiful fountains here and along Market Street in downtown St. Louis. But not just in St. Louis. This is being seen across the country, from Hawaii to Washington, D.C., from Maine to Texas, right?
Chicago, Pittsburgh, Charleston, South Carolina, San Diego. So, of course, hello to all of you, and happy Independence Day weekend for all of you joining us today.
Absolutely. We have a great opening performance coming up, and I think you're really going to enjoy that. That's always one of the highlights of the parade every year, so we can get that started. It salutes the men and women of our United States Armed Forces. More than 100 performers from ages 7, and you're going
to
love the kids in this, to 70, pay tribute to those who serve and protect us, inspire us, and of course, give us hope. That's what this 4th of July holiday is all about, our independence as a country.
We also have to bring up the weather here. You are a meteorologist. Everyone has been excited about this, and you delivered, buddy.
It's just about perfect today.
It is.
A nice little overcast so it doesn't get too hot and humid. You know how it is in the Midwest in the summertime with the humidity. So today we say thank you for the freedom that the sacrifices have made possible, and the sacrifices that have made our freedom possible over the years. Here's our opening number.
Thank you. say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming? And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
That puts a chill up my spine right there.
Didn't it? Absolutely incredible. The singer is a St. Louis native. We appreciate Sam Krause joining us today. And we also appreciate this guy joining us today, Mr. Mike Hart, the Midwest Area President of Regions Bank, the presenting sponsor of today's parade. How
are you
doing?
Salute you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Ken. Laura, nice to see you.
Nice to see you. It is such a special day in St. Louis. Also a special weekend for our entire country. Why did Regions Bank decide to get involved with this year's parade?
What a great day. I mean, we had such a good time last year at the parade and working with you guys. And this is really a celebration for all of us as one country coming together downtown to watch a great parade and be with a lot of people we really enjoy being with.
It just, and I don't know why, but every year it just seems to take on more importance as we salute our troops, which is a common theme every year for this parade. And I know that must mean a lot to you.
Oh, we I'm very proud of all of our associates who are involved in the community, but we so delight in working with the veterans. I mean, active military veterans, there's a huge military presence in
sure.
the St. Louis area, both over the long term and currently. It's got Air Force Base, so we're happy to be part of this celebration.
Well, thank you so much for your participation and your support. Couldn't do it without you mm-hmm. and all of our fine sponsors, but especially your group. And we are looking forward to a very exciting morning and afternoon here in downtown St. Louis for this America's Birthday Parade.
Mm-hmm. We will be right back. Why is Regions so committed to making St. Louis a better place?
It's one of the biggest holidays of the year, and we just view it as a celebration of our community, and it's great to be part of it, and we're happy to partner with KMOB.
You don't just do big events like this.
Corporate values are to make our community stronger. Well, we've got about 500 associates. We give all the associates a day off, a day of caring to do what they want. We also organize team-based not-for-profit volunteer activities. And I see it as something we should never stop doing.
I've been a proud and loyal Regions customer for about 7 years now, is because I knew no matter what I was doing, where I was going, there would be a bank close to me.
St. Louis is one of our growth markets. It's been identified for the company as a growth market. And over the next several years, we'll be spending tens of millions of dollars on branches. No matter what happens in your life, you're going to need someone to help you with your finances. Very few people can go it alone.
There's a super fun city, a quick getaway, where there's so much excitement you need more than a day. St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family. Infinity plus a ton. It's got works of wonder, things to wow your brain, an amazing pet performance all aboard on the train. Some museums are historic, some hit the right blues notes, maybe catch a cards game, whatever paddles your boat. Yeah, St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family. Infinity plus a ton.
Henderson Ala Olima, a major in the United States Army. I like to say hello to my husband. Hi, sweetie. Serving has always been something that I've seen called to do. The Army's mission, the families, the soldiers, all of those things are nested within my own core values. Happy 4th of July, St. Louis.
Salute the Troops is brought to you by Lakeside Exteriors, thanking those who serve for protecting all the places we call home.
Welcome back to this year's America's Birthday Parade, the 135th America's Birthday Parade from downtown St. Louis. The theme of this year's parade, great things are happening, and it's presented by VP of St. Louis.
And in fact, the very first float that you are going to see is the tidal float. Great things are happening. You see it right here. And today we are celebrating what is right with the world, from great music to great talent. Here is the very first Great Things Are Happening float.
All right. Beautiful float. You're going to see a lot of those here today. Followed up this morning by the Mounted Bengal Lancers, clothed in their red jackets and feathered helmets, black riding boots. The VP Bengal Lancers first appeared in the 1935 parade, and they've been a crowd favorite here ever since. And you can certainly tell why. These are some beautiful animals, well taken care of, and we always look forward to seeing them up front in our parade. Their uniforms are modeled after the British Royal Mounted Bengal Lancers from way back in the 19th century in India.
And you can hear the applause from the crowd. Love seeing those horses.
Absolutely. By the way, this year's parade is taking place. Our particular location here is in front of a very famous St. Louis Union Station here in downtown St. Louis, and that's the background you are seeing, the beautiful building behind all of the floats.
And right now, we have another float making its way down.
That is the Queen of Love and Beauty.
And she is in the white dress on this float, absolutely gorgeous.
And following his royal guard is the Veiled Prophet, known as the VP, and by tradition of more than 100 years, remains anonymous. We never know the identity of the Veiled, you can see the veil there, the Veiled Prophet.
Beside him is Miss Eliza Dooley Johnson, this year's VP Queen of Love and Beauty. And they have a lot of people with them, Kent. That is the royal court.
Ah. That goes back a long ways. I remember that when I was a child, the Veiled Prophet Parade here in St. Louis. So it's been around for a long time, longer than me. And there's not much, as you know.
That's true.
It's been around longer than me.
Glad you mentioned that.
All right, next up is the Court of Love and Beauty. Following the Queen is the VP's Court of Love and Beauty, celebrated for their achievements in community service. The special maids of honor are Maria Hawes Brennan,
Lindsay Elise Bauer,
Mary Ava Patterson Carnell,
Cameron Isabel Neiman,
and Carolyn St. John Danforth.
Finally, Jody Calhoun Jones.
Congratulations, girls. Beautiful backdrop.
Here we have the 135th U.S. Army Band, and let's call it the great 135th U.S. Army Band, marching in the parade today as they have for the past decade.
They're under the command of Chief Warrant Officer Robert Springer and First Sergeant David McKay. The 135th Army Band provides music to inspire soldiers, the will to fight and win, and foster the support of our citizens and promote U.S. interests at home and also abroad. And they are followed up today by the Military Vehicle Preservation Association,
which it was established on our nation's 200th birthday in 1976. It's a worldwide organization of collectors, preservationists, and historians who restore and display U.S. and international military transports.
Some of this stuff goes all the way back to World War I, World War II, things like that. So, a big part of the parade every year, and good to see all of that stuff preserved.
And we just saw a little bit an American Eagle making its way up Market Street right now. That was a gorgeous balloon.
That's Do Something Great, I believe. Mm-hmm.
By Commerce Bank. And in fact, I think we're going to show you a little bit more of it. It is sponsored, again, by Commerce Bank. Talented young dancers from the Professional Dance Center, and they are going to be performing to the song Can't Stop That Feeling by Justin Timberlake.
There's the Commerce Bank float.
as they make their way up Market Street right to Union Station to get in position. Something we have to mention, Kent, so many of the performers you see today will be doing multiple performances. Once they're done with this, they're going to run into Union Station, change clothes, get ready for a next choreographed routine. Absolutely incredible.
Yeah, you're going to see. That's right. How many changes are they making?
Some are going to be making 10. 10 in 2 hours.
Now, here's the thing. So they have to change clothes and they have to remember all the dances.
And
so
here they go.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on, lock the way we rock it. So don't stop.
All right, well, go back and change clothes. Quickly.
Yes, quickly. That got me dancing.
They have a lot more performances, a lot of those dancers do, as we go through the afternoon here and into our parade. So there we see our next float, the American Eagle, and that is sponsored by Merit, a great St. Louis company. This symbolic American Eagle is volunteered from Merit and proudly guides the Eagle through the air. It's believed to exist only on this continent, the American Eagle, chosen by Congress in 1782, of course, as the emblem of our young nation. And you know, there was some argument about making the eagle the bird, the symbol of our country. Did you know that?
I did not know
that. Did you know what bird they wanted to make?
Please tell me.
The turkey.
No.
They really did. There was some discussion. I was there. That's how I know.
Mm-hmm.
There was some discussion early on that they wanted to make the turkey. And they said, no, let's just eat the turkey on Thanksgiving.
I'm
and we'll
okay
have the
with
eagle.
That. Yes, I'm good with that.
So good to see. We have a lot of eagles around
the
St. Louis area, especially
and
in the wintertime.
That's so special. You could be running at any of our parks, look up, and there is an American eagle flying right above you.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we hope you're enjoying this presentation of the 135th America's Birthday Parade. We have a lot of floats coming up, a lot of bands. We can even see some of them walking by
away
as we speak. And we are coming to you from downtown St. Louis and, of course, right in front of beautiful Union Station. The theme of this year's parade, great things are happening, and they really are. We can see some of our old Cardinal vintage ball players down there.
Kent, I know you're excited about this one. It looks like this float is the I Got the Part float, sponsored by Hush Blackwell. I know you love it because the Muni Kids will be performing on this.
Oh, we love our Muni Kids. The Muni stands for Municipal Opera. It's an outdoor theater here in St. Louis, and they are known for putting out some incredible talent that then goes on and ends up performing on Broadway and around the world in musical theater. You're going to see the Muni Kids. Again, the name of this one is I Got the Part. It is sponsored by Hush Blackwell and Well, let's listen to the Muni Kids perform a song from their 2017 season.
Under the sea,
How much fun, Kent. I think you know what that song was from, right? I hope so.
Yes, I do. And Ariel is a big part of our life at home with my daughters. So, yes.
The Little Mermaid, absolutely love it, which just finished a run at the Muni. And coming up next, we have the
Corsan Cop Car. Yeah, just take a look at these zany cops and their prisoners. Oh, those look like some pretty scary prisoners. The cops don't look so good either.
We're happy they're not part of our St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department.
Which we are very proud of,
so
I might
proud
add.
Proud of.
All right, I don't know. It's hard to tell the cops from the cons on that one, I
in
think.
That one.
All right. Got a great a crowd assembled here, and out amongst that crowd is our own Matt Chambers. He's keeping track of all the... Oh, there you are. Hey, Matt.
Hey, I'm walking along. Honored to be walking along, Kent and Laura, with the honorary Grand Marshal of today's parade. I want you to meet Major General John C. Flournoy. He's stationed at Scott Air Force Base just in our backyard. We talk about how great things are happening here in the St. Louis area. Let me tell you, the things that this guy's doing at Scott Air Force Base means that great things happen across the globe. Major General, how are you?
I'm living the dream.
I bet you are. You got the best seat in the house today, sir.
Not a bad one. It's a real honor, real honor.
So you're the Chief of Staff for Transportation Command there at Scott Air Force Base. Tell me exactly what it is that you folks are doing.
Yeah, so some people would say that we move stuff around the world, but what we really do is give the President and Department of Defense a lot of options, so it's great.
How many men and women are under your command?
So actually there's about 140,000 men and women from all the services that are actually serving in the transportation industry.
Well, thank you so much for your service. How's the view today? Are you enjoying your honorary Grand Marshal duty?
Fantastic, and as usual, the St. Louis and the surrounding areas are so supportive of our military men and women, and we can't thank you enough for it.
Please express our gratitude to the men and women that work under you as well.
We definitely do that. Thanks so much for all your support.
Great. Of course. Happy Independence Day to you. Thank you again for your service. Major General John C. Flournoy, guys, you think we have stressful days. Imagine coordinating, 150,000 pieces of equipment and personnel around the globe.
So yes. True, Matt. And we are so appreciative of all of our men and women in uniform in the military. And in fact, you are seeing part of them. That's U.S. Transcom.
Yeah, just a few of the members of U.S. Transcom. The men and women of U.S. Transcom come from all branches of the military, as well as civilian life, to help keep America safe and strong. And we certainly thank all of them. And everybody listening, and every family that is making sacrifices.
Absolutely.
As their loved ones serve our country, and for all of their dedication, of course. Great Surprises is our next float, surprising us from way back in the prehistoric era. Great Surprises float.
Take a close look. Those are dinosaurs on those floats, or on that float. Yeah. They walked the Earth millions of years ago, but these dinosaurs, Kent, they look pretty alive.
Yeah, they could bite, I'm afraid. You gotta watch out for them.
We also have to mention that the VP starts working for the next year's parade just 2 weeks after the end of the current parade.
Yeah, and one of the things that you may not know about them, but the Triners are a big part of it, just about everything in this town. And the Moolah Shriners YOMO Mini Patrol is zipping and whizzing behind them. You saw all the go-karts, they're always a favorite. So there's our go-karts. All the kids always look forward to the crazy drivers in the go-karts.
Stay with us. You are watching the 2017 VP Parade live from downtown St. Louis.
Chevrolet was founded in 1902 as Weber Implements. It was right there on where the arch is right now, is where the showroom was, with a warehouse across the river in Illinois. And it was wagons, tools, plows, and that type of stuff. So a few years later, the car was invented. And so we started selling cars of different makes, Hupmobile, Lozier, Pierce Arrow. And next thing you know, we were selling Chryslers on Locust Street. Very early 50s, we started selling Chevrolets. So ever since then, we've been Chevrolet, with American, number one brand. And we moved to our location in West County in the late 60s. And we opened up our two branches in 1989 and 1993. We've kind of grown to the largest in the Midwest. So selling Chevrolets, it's been fun. It's a great American brand. And we're proud of our 115 years of being around and serving St. Louis. Happy Independence Day, America, from Weber Chevrolet.
Allen Roofing, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. Allen Roofing, doing your homework and honoring our heroes. aroofing.net.
My name is Staff Sergeant William Benline. I'm in the Missouri National Guard. I work with Homeland Response Force as the Logistics Operations NCO. St. Louis is a very giving community, and they really support the military, and it's very welcoming to be able to serve here in the Missouri National Guard. I just want to wish everyone a happy Independence Day.
Salute the Troops is brought to you by Lakeside Exteriors, thanking those who serve for protecting all the places we call home. MedExchange, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. MedExchange, providing and servicing medical equipment in the St. Louis metro areas and honoring our hometown heroes. MedExchangeSTL.com.
And we're back at the 135th America's Birthday Parade theme. Great things are happening, and great things really are happening here in downtown St. Louis. Up next is the Belleville High School Band.
Belleville East High School Band, the Lancers. Let's take a listen.
Great job. That's what I'm talking about. A wonderful performance by the Belleville East High School marching band under the direction of Mark Tessero. Belleville East has won numerous awards and marched in Chicago's St. Patrick's Day Parade. I'll tell you what, we have two major parades in St. Louis every year. So the marching bands, the high school marching bands in this area are unbelievable because they all want to be in these parades and they travel all over the country. We have to remind ourselves sometimes that they're only high school bands.
And we have to mention a lot of money is on the line for them today.
That's
Kent.
Exactly right.
Yes, they are competing in the Liberty Drum Challenge, $10,000 grand prize. And in fact, we hear another band right now. This is the 932nd Air Lift Wing, which is located at Scott Air Force Base in Illinois. It's a group of flying heroes that undertakes missions around the globe. We are so proud of Scott Air Force Base.
We absolutely are. All right, Miss Missouri is out there right now. Outstanding teen, Helena Haberer.
And Miss Missouri joins her, Jennifer Lee Davis. Miss Missouri, Jennifer Lee Davis, is a native of St. Louis and Kent. She is a published author.
Wow.
She plans on becoming a physician's assistant. Her platform is Diversity Matters.
And next to her is Miss Missouri Outstanding Teen 2017, and that's Helena Haberer. Helena was adopted from Nepal. And raised in Branson, mm-hmm. which is in southwest Missouri. She is a high school senior ranked fourth in her class.
Now we see the spirit of St. Louis float. We love this one here in St. Louis, Kent. Of course, the historic original became famous nearly a century ago when Charles Lindbergh made the world's first solo nonstop transatlantic flight from New York to Paris.
And here comes our second inflatable in this year's America's Birthday Parade, Uncle Sam, sponsored by Edward Jones. Uncle Sam, of course, has all those employee volunteers that help him move around down there. This is a big day for them. This giant balloon 5 stories tall, hoards more than 5,000 cubic feet of helium.
And we have to remind you that Uncle Sam wants you to do great things in your community.
I don't know why he's holding a microphone there.
Trying to take our job, I guess.
You have to wonder, don't
Maybe.
You?
Maybe.
Yeah.
But as you see him glide by, the backdrop we want to mention is gorgeous Union Station right in the heart of downtown St. Louis. And coming up next, we have the Muskoda High School Band out of Muskoda, Illinois.
They are 100 plus strong, the Muskoda High School Band. They are directed by Jordan Gouge. Muskoda High School is located near Scott Air Force Base over in Illinois, so they live a military family life over there.
60% of the kids in that district are military kids.
Yep. And this year, the band is excited to perform in the Chick-fil-A Bowl later this year in Atlanta, Georgia. Can you imagine that? Very exciting. Again,
Absolutely.
We have to just continue to remind ourselves that these are high school bands because they sound fantastic. Let's give a listen. Again, the Muskoda High School Band. Sounded fantastic.
It did.
Looks like they're lining up to perform there in front of Union Station. Oh, look at that. That's the Intergalactic Border Patrol. You got to watch them. Wait a minute. That guy snuck behind the gate. Keep an eye out for that guy.
Oh, boy. They have super soakers with them?
You got to watch those
men
guys.
Men in black, I am worried it's an intrepid group of secret agents. The Intergalactic Border Patrol is charged with protection of the entire galaxy.
Yeah.
They're armed and they consider themselves dangerous, Kent.
As they should.
As they should, as they make their way up Market Street. And pretty soon we are going to see a float that the entertainment producer of this year's parade has been so excited about. I had a chance to speak with her on Monday, just a few days out from the parade. This is Everything Old Is Great Again, and it is sponsored by Butler's Pantry. And in fact, they're starting the performance
bang, bang,
right now.
With the trolley, ting, ting, ting with the bell. Sing, sing, sing with my heartstrings. From the moment I saw him, I fell. Bump, bump, bump with the buzzer. Bump, bump, bump with the bray. Bump, bump, bump with my heartstrings. When he smiled, I could feel the car shake. He tipped his hat and took a seat. He said he hoped he hadn't stepped up on my feet. He asked my name, I held my breath. I couldn't speak because he scared me half to death. Buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer. Plop, plop, plop went the wheel. Stop, stop, stop went my heartstrings. From the morning he started and I was enough. And he stopped. And before it was grand, he took hold of me and it was grand just to stand with his hand.
That is Anita Jackson, accompanied by the Jazz St. Louis All-Stars Band for the Trolley Song, Kent, from a very famous movie.
Uh-huh.
Can you name
it? Meet Me in St. Louis.
Love it.
One of my faves, one of our faves. There's the Honorable Lyda Crewson, the mayor of St. Louis, serving her first term, her first opportunity to ride in a parade, and I'll bet she is overwhelmed.
Yes, she was just elected in April, and it was really historic, Kent. She is the first woman to lead the city of St. Louis forward, but she is not exactly new to serving the community. She has been an alderwoman for over 20 years, and we wish her great luck in doing so many great things in the city. And up next right there, Steve Stanger, who is the Honorable Steve Stanger, the St. Louis County Executive. I just ran into him having dinner the other night, having fun. He has been the county executive since 2015. For people not familiar with what a county executive is, I always describe it as basically the mayor of a county.
Yeah.
St. Louis County.
Kind of that. Yeah, that's a way to look at it. That's a very good way to look at it. He has degrees in law and accounting.
He can do it all.
He's smart.
Very smart.
Yeah. All right, we're going to take a break. This is the 135th America's Birthday Parade, coming to you from downtown St. Louis in front of world-famous Union Station, presented by VP of St. Louis. We have so many more bands and floats and clowns and children and balloons and things coming up. Don't miss it. Stay with us.
New Balance St. Louis, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. New Balance St. Louis, locally owned stores in Richmond Heights, Creve Coeur, and Fairview Heights.
Legend has it that a fabled monarch traveled the world in 1878 in search of a community on which to bestow his goodwill. He brought a huge celebration to the streets to provide a gift to the city of St. Louis. The VP organization has hosted a parade for 135 years. The VP organization is working to make St. Louis a better place to live for all and to celebrate our home city with this great parade.
There's a weekend vacation, a one-tank trip in a nearby city you won't want to skip. St. Louis is the stop for non-stop fun. So much fun for your family. Infinity plus a ton. There's museums full of art and super fun slides. Upside-down concretes, twisty, turny rides. Houses full of magic, some with butterflies. Gardens growing flowers, parks with giant eyes. St. Louis is the stop for non-stop fun. So much fun for your family. Infinity plus a ton.
The freedoms we enjoy are only possible because of the sacrifices made by our military. The Kauffman Fund provides support to St. Louis area veterans and their families who have been deprived of life's basic necessities. We work to bring the entire veterans community together, providing assistance with food, clothing, housing, employment, counseling, dental care, and more. If you're a veteran in need or interested in supporting St. Louis area veterans, visit thekauffmanfund.org.
The 100th PGA Championship heads to Belle Reve Country Club in 2018. St. Louis's Gateway to the West invites you to be a part of history. Watch more top 100 golfers than any other field compete for the Wanamaker Trophy. Register now on pgachampionship.com/tickets for early access to ticket options.
Welcome back to America's Birthday Parade. The theme of this year's parade is Great Things Are Happening, and the next performance float we have will be Great Kicks, sponsored by iHeartMedia, a performance by the Cheetah Girls.
Oh, the Cheetah Girls?
The Cheetah Girls.
Oh, I've heard of the Cheetah Girls. They're very good.
They will be saluting America's Road, which is, of course, Route 66.
Route 66. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Route 66.
fantastic job. And Route 66, of course, Kent, begins in Chicago, runs through the St. Louis area all the way to Santa Monica, California.
All the way to the Santa Monica Pier.
I've been there.
Yeah, I have too. It's a great run from Chicago all the way out there.
Absolutely.
A lot of motorcycle groups will make that run. That's a great kind of a bucket list thing. Oh, we love the USO of Missouri. We welcome the James S. McDonnell USO float. The USO keeps America's armed forces members connected to friends, family, and home as they travel in service to our nation.
Military members and USO volunteers are abroad today in tribute and aboard to this. The float, the USO's mission of supporting our brave troops. Something interesting, Kent, the USO of Missouri is private. They do not receive any federal funding. They rely on all the good people in our area to donate money to continue doing the fantastic things they do for our soldiers and their families.
And if you've ever been to the Lambert St. Louis Airport on Thanksgiving and see all the troops headed out, you know what a tremendous job they do. Miss Michigan is Heather Kendrick, the newly crowned Miss Michigan 2017, a native of Ann Arbor. She is an MBA student. She is an MBA student at the University of Michigan. She's going to be a CEO of a performing arts organization.
Well, she is in the right place.
Yeah,
absolutely. We also need to give a big thanks to the Lou Fuse Automotive Network. You see all the queens on their gorgeous convertibles, all donated today by Lou Fuse.
And next up is the band from Hazelwood Central High School. The 65-member Hazelwood Central High School marching band is directed by Mark Thomas.
They will be performing God Bless the USA. They are part of the big band competition as they get into position to dazzle us.
Yeah, keep in mind, every one of these bands is part of this competition today that there's a lot of money on the line, right?
10 grand.
You know, these bands are always raising money to travel and go to these competitions and to parades across the country. So it's very important that they raise as much money as they can. Let's give a listen to the Hazelwood Central High School Band.
Actually making their way right by. And check out this guy, Kent. If you have been in St. Louis for even a minute, you will recognize him. That is Fire Chief Dennis Jinkerson, a third generation firefighter in our great city of St. Louis. I have a feeling those are two of his grandchildren. Look at that smile on his face. We are so proud of the work the Fire Chief Jinkerson does and all the work that the firefighters in our great city does.
Very proud tradition of firefighting here in St. Louis, and we love them all very much, and their families too. And no more or less than our acting police commissioner and all of our City of St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department, Lieutenant Colonel Lawrence O'Toole, here on behalf of the St. Louis Metro Police Department. And Lieutenant Colonel Lawrence O'Toole is acting commissioner right now and doing a very good job.
He has been a police officer since 1984. He is also a graduate of the FBI National Academy in Quantico, Virginia. We love our police officers, our firefighters, our first responders in the great city of St. Louis, taking off some beads and giving it to a parade goer right there. So many of our police officers and firefighters are out in the community, Kent, doing so much volunteer work. Some of the firefighters go to burn units to visit children. Some of the police officers volunteer at homeless shelters.
And from District 2, Sergeant Thomas Lake finds ways to turn problem areas into environments of positive social stability. We salute them all the fine officers and civilian colleagues, true American heroes. And
absolutely.
No more or less than our beautiful St. Louis Fire Department, they are true heroes as well.
We salute all of them. And in fact, this is the St. Louis Fire Department True Heroes. I don't know if that's a float.
I wouldn't call it a float. I'd call it a big hat on top of a fire engine is what I'd call it.
And that's why we keep you around, Kent.
Each of the St. Louis Fire Department firefighters and civilian personnel atop this vintage truck dedicates his or her time and talents through personal volunteer efforts.
We've mentioned a few of them. Fire Captain Larry Conley is on this float. He volunteers with the Midwest Children's Burn Camp for survivors of burn injuries. Also, firefighter Tom Moore is aboard that, who helps feed the homeless. And again, true fire department heroes, each and every one of them, each and every day.
Boy, I had an opportunity last night, actually, at a fireworks display to look inside a modern fire truck. Wow.
Fantastic,
looks like a spaceship in there. They are really in control of a lot of stuff. And one of the things they showed me was they now have a light on the side of the truck that shows how much water is left in the truck.
Oh, that's interesting.
And they can see that from a distance. And I never thought, because, you know, they don't know. And then they can look back at the truck and see by this brilliant light how they're doing on water. Just some of the stuff. I don't know. That just really impressed me.
It does. Something that impresses me, Kent.
Your dog, I know.
Yes, my dog, of course.
I still say that's a wannabe dog. That's not
fine.
A real dog.
Whatever.
He's, what, 5 years old and he still hasn't grown up.
Well, you haven't either. This float is great dogs and cats, and it is sponsored by Purina Pet Care. We love Purina, located right here in downtown St. Louis. Where would we be without the love of our cats and dogs? So fun.
And they're followed up by the Corusan Corp fire truck. And Matt Chambers is down on the parade route with a guest, I believe.
Well,
let's
guys,
check in with him.
I probably have a guest. They just don't know it yet. None of these people have realized until right about now, I think, that they're actually on live television. I wanted to know, how do you get these seats? These are like the best seats of the parade. How does that happen?
I entered on iHeartRadio.
I gotcha. So you're one of our iHeartRadio winners.
I am.
How's the view been so far?
Awesome.
Has it?
Yes.
Look, guys, Uncle Sam showed up.
Hey!
Isn't that a pro? I want you to look right and see that camera across the street. Look right there and say, I want you.
I want you.
I knew I recognized him from somewhere. Right, guys?
That's awesome. Boy, as busy as Uncle Sam would be on the 4th of July, and he took time to come to our parade here in St. Louis.
No kidding, right?
How about that? Thank you,
Matt. It's just like Santa Claus showing up on Thanksgiving Day. Who thought? Who would have thought?
St. Michael Albertville High School Band is moving into the performance area now. They join us from St. Michael, Minnesota, and the St. Michael Albertville High School Marching Band.
And they have 80 members. They will be playing the St. Louis Blues March.
All right. Also saw the St. Louis Ambulance there, a tongue-in-cheek tribute to those in the healthcare community who really do provide the necessary care for us when we are sick. We have thank those happy healers for joining us. And here is Miss Arkansas International 2017.
Haley Bird. She just received this title. She is a senior marketing major at Southern Arkansas University. Her service platform is Bully Free Starts With Me. Kent, that is a great message for today.
It sure is.
Absolutely beautiful. Thank you for joining us.
It makes us pay more attention when they're beautiful, too, for some reason.
For some reason.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Miss Arkansas, thank you. Oh,
who is that
there
guy?
He is. That's the St. Louis Blues Cruiser.
With Louis.
We love our St. Louis Blues. That's our NHL franchise here in St. Louis. Great history of hockey here in St. Louis. Even though we haven't managed to win the cup yet, we absolutely love our Blues. And
we've
this
gotten
is
close.
Pretty much known as a baseball town, but the Blues have really become a major part of this town, and we love our
Can
Blues.
Can we say it together?
Let's go, Blues! Man. We got a big horn that they blow down at the Scott Trade Center.
Coming up next, Independence Square Puppet Theater.
This is the Independence Square Puppet Theater featuring the Drum and Fife Corps Puppeteers. Kelly's Cuties from Kelly's Batons and Palms perform to that patriotic favorite. It's a grand old flag.
It's a high-flying flag.
Yes, it is.
Gorgeous floats. And again, just a reminder, these started getting worked on, Kent, 50 weeks ago.
Yeah,
just 2 weeks after last year's VP parade.
And they'll start 2 weeks from now. And in fact, the reality is they've already started planning for next year's parade. So let's hear them.
Mm-hmm.
Independence Square Puppet Theater. Fantastic job to all the gals and Kelly's cuties from Kelly's Batons and Palms.
You know, St. Louis is a place of icons. Mm-hmm. Things like the Arch. For us here, Union Square, our St. Louis Cardinals and Busch Stadium.
And this.
None more so than our world-famous Budweiser Clydesdales. Of course, the world headquarters for Anheuser-Busch all these years, and now InBev is here in St. Louis, a proud tradition at Anheuser-Busch since 1933. And you can hear how the St. Louisans really love them.
Love them. And in fact, only the finest horses, Kent, are chosen. They must meet strict requirements in appearance and temperament. And every year, the Clydesdales travel 100,000 miles to participate in hundreds of parades, festivals, state fairs, and sporting events. We absolutely love them. And I have a feeling a couple people might be having a Budweiser this weekend.
I think you're probably right. I may be one of them. And after that, I may go fill my cart at Schnucks, local grocery store, of course. This is the Schnucks Big Cart, sponsored by Schnucks Markets. It isn't just big. It is the world's largest shopping cart, powered by a V8 there, a blown-out V8. And he usually gives the engine a good rev every year when he comes up.
We hear it.
And that's another very popular day. I don't know how long that one's been around. Since 1966, the big shopping cart's been around here in St. Louis.
We have another float coming up. Look out, pirates have landed in the U.S. of...
I see what you need.
I see what you did there.
Watch out. Keep your belongings close for these scruffy thieves. They're looking for treasure along the parade route.
And you can hear the crowd loving them.
Well, that's because they're throwing out candy.
Oh, of course.
They'd love me if I threw out candy.
Did you bring me any?
I did not.
Oh,
but these next guys did. It's our family. There
I
they
recognize
are.
Recognize some of them.
I know them all. There's Katie, my girlfriend. And there's April and Kendall.
Kendall doing cartwheels. That is your daughter. She is so cute. And look, some of our friends brought their dogs.
There's Matt Sesney. I see Courtney. And I see Corey. I feel like the romper room teacher now.
Absolutely. This is the KMOV Storm Mode Silverado you see right there.
Megan Danahay.
Part of the meteorology team. Kent, you are part of the Forewarned Storm team. And there are two more. We have Matt Chambers.
Yeah, I get a little nervous when I have to walk next to this guy, guys. For those that aren't familiar with this, is Channel 4's chief investigative reporter, Chris Negus. I'm not in any sort of trouble, am I?
You're not in any trouble, but I'll tell you what, I'm having a hard time competing with the pirates just ahead of us.
That is a tough act to follow.
They got the beads and the confetti cannons. Next year, I will be prepared.
I believe you. We'll look for you in your full regalia. I got to ask this guy a question. Chief Meteorologist Steve Templeton, ladies and gentlemen. How is it that you get to ride in the truck, partner?
This needs to be explained, because I have a bit of a foot issue. I had a procedure on my foot yesterday. I can't.
The procedure.
Trust me, it hurts.
Well, heal up, and happy for it, partner.
Happy for it. Have a great day. Beautiful weather.
I know. Way to come through for us, partner. That's the guy you want to thank right there.
That's
Send the
it.
Thank you notes to Chief Meteorologist Steve Templeton.
All right. Thank you, Matthew. That's our family right there. We love them all, too. Really is a great station to work at.
It is.
All right, next up, the John Ford Highland Pipe Band performing Armed Service Medley and traditional Scottish music is the John Ford Highland Pipe Band, and it is directed by Claire Kujak.
It has been a fixture of this parade for 34 years, and the band makes dozens of appearances each year in places like Chicago, Boston, Philadelphia, and New York. And if you are joining us from Chicago, maybe D.C., maybe San Diego, the other 60 cities that this parade is airing, we say hello to all of you and thank you for joining us.
Oh, there's Horton.
Does he hear something right now?
I think he does.
Maybe a who?
Say hello to Horton, who just had to be where great things are happening today. Watch out for his rowdy handlers, though. They have mischief in their eyes. How often do you see an elephant sitting
like
in a tree,
that.
Right?
Not often.
I've seen a few pink ones in my time.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Well, we're glad he could make it to St. Louis to be with us on this Independence Day weekend.
I think he hears a who, if I'm not mistaken.
I think he does. Those big ears.
Next up is a Persian Gulf Air, a 5-ton, 6x6 M939 military vehicle. Designed during the Vietnam War, this vehicle is still in use around the world today. You're watching coverage of the 135th America's Birthday Parade coming to you from St. Louis, Missouri. We are proud to present it, and there's a lot more bands and floats and surprises to come.
Stick with us. We'll be right back. And we are back with the 135th America's Birthday Parade. The Alton High School Band just making its way down Market Street, performing Defense of Liberty from Alton, Illinois. 165 members in this as they get into position, Kent. We will listen to them make their eighth appearance in this parade.
I laugh because, again, we have to remind ourselves these are high school bands.
And they are fantastic.
They
this
sure
one,
are.
Again, from Alton, Illinois, directed by Alyssa Overman, Stephen James. They are nervous, Kent, because all of the bands that are in this today could potentially win $10,000. Big band contest.
Yeah. A lot
We're
of money
so
at stake.
So excited for them.
That'd get them to one of these bowl games, mm-hmm. or one of the other parades. This is the Gift of Gardens float, representing the team of young women who have given their time to improve the St. Louis area as part of the VP Community Service Initiative. The float is dedicated to the memory of First Lieutenant Roslyn Schulte, a former VP Maid of Honor.
She was the first female U.S. Air Force Academy graduate killed in support of the Operation Iraqi Freedom. She received the National Intelligence Medal of Valor, awarded for courage above and beyond the call of duty. We salute her service, all the service of those in uniform on this weekend and really every day, Kent.
And we're going to take another break here of the 135th running of America's Birthday Parade, presented by VP of St. Louis. Great things really are happening. And there will be more great things happening as we continue our parade coverage right after a short break. Stay with us.
When you create jobs, then you create buyers of everything. And that just grows the economy. And that helps everybody. Okay, so we have over 500 employees. Very, very proud of that. Every year it's bigger and bigger. It's really even hard to get them all together in one place anymore because there's not any place that fits us, but that's okay because we'll keep growing. Nothing can run in this country if there's not people that jobs, creating jobs for wealth for people to pay their taxes and to pay the things that they want to do. So, or to buy things from other people to keep those jobs going. So it's all interconnected. So we have to have a booming economy. Creating jobs is a big part of it. And I love the fact that so many of our people and are hired in by us and they stay with us till they retire because that gives them a nice stable job. They raise their families and we get to know them and it's all one big happy family. Happy Independence Day, America, from Weber Chevrolet.
Randall's Wines and Spirits, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's Birthday Parade. Randall's Wines and Spirits, now delivering downtown, Central West End, and Clayton. ShopRandalls.com.
My name is Staff Sergeant Ashley Caldwell. I am the training NCO with HHD 70th Troop Command. Serving means freedom to me. It feels great to put on this uniform and watching my son look at me as a hero. I would like to say hi to all of my friends and family. Happy 4th of July, St. Louis.
Salute the Troops is brought to you by Lakeside Exteriors, thanking those who serve for protecting all the places we call home. Gateway Powder Coating, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. Gateway Powder Coating, bringing your medal back to life and honoring our hometown heroes. GatewayPowderCoat.com.
Welcome back to the 135th America's Birthday Parade. We are showing you the logo in the middle of Market Street in downtown St. Louis. We have thousands of people, Kent, along the parade route, smiling, and look at all the red, white, and blue we have out there.
And as you know, I love me some St. Louis blues. Oh, I'm in a blues band, and St. Louis, for those of you around the country who maybe aren't familiar with our town, is a great place for blues, and you're hearing great blues on the bayou. This float titled Great Blues on the Bayou honors the music that was first heard in the Deep South so many years back. All right, on your next visit to St. Louis, if you visit the Arch, maybe see a Cardinals game, I sure hope you'll stop by the National Blues Museum. I'm a member down there, and it's a fantastic, fantastic exhibit that they have here in St. Louis. That was Skeet Rogers and the Inner City Blues Band from our newly opened National Blues Museum.
Up next, we have Miss Black America, Nicole Lynn Hibbert. Look at that crown, Kent. Yeah. That is absolutely gorgeous. She is 28 years old, hails from Wilmington, Delaware. Nicole's platform during her reign is domestic violence prevention and awareness. That is a great cause
it
we
is.
Can all support.
I love the, you know, I mean, we traditionally call them beauty queens, but they bring more and more of these issues to light, and I love that that fact that they do that now. That's
She's
awesome.
Doing great work during her time reigning. And then who's this guy?
That would
Kung Fu Panda?
I think it's Kung Fu Panda. I know that one.
He is sponsored by Weber Chevrolet. He's accompanied today by employees, family members, and friends of the Weber Chevrolet team. He is tall, Kent,
yes.
40 feet tall. And legend has it that our panda overcame great obstacles in his quest to become a great warrior.
Well, and it takes a coordinated effort, as you can plainly see here, of a bunch of sober people, because they all have to move in unison, and they do that up and down Market Street here in downtown St. Louis so that they can show off the great floats and balloons that we have here in the 135th America's Birthday Parade.
We love the balloons, we love the bands.
And we love our Staunton High School band from Staunton, Illinois, and they are returning for their 10th year with director Brian Lauder.
There are 127 performers in this band. They bring us Defense of Liberty, and they recently performed, Kent, at the most magical place on earth, Walt Disney World in Orlando.
That's fantastic. As another one of our high school bands, you're gonna hear them perform, and you're gonna say, really? That's a high school band.
They get into position, we will let you listen to the Staunton High School Band.
Thank you. And our Matt Chambers is down now on Market Street. Thanks, by the way, to Staunton High School Band. Matt, you know, we're known for our baseball. We're known for our hockey here
in
St. Louis. And another sport that we are well known for in this community, we have fantastic golf courses. Mm-hmm. One of the best in the world is Belrive Country Club. And because of that, the PGA has chosen Belrive for many major tournaments, not the least of which will be the 100th running of the PGA Championship next year. We are so excited about that.
Is that not incredible, Kent and Laura? How appropriate that the theme of the parade this year is great things are happening, because that we continue to see great things happen in St. Louis. Could not be more excited about next year. The 100th PGA Championship comes to town. This guy knows a thing or two about that. I think he just took a bath. Barry Deitch, the director of the 100th PGA Championship. How are you?
I'm nervous after seeing this. I'm nervous now.
We produce things up in St. Louis, pal.
Obviously, I'm a little taken back. I did not expect this at all. So it makes me very excited about next year, to say the truth. I mean, I'm stoked.
Well, we're extremely excited that you've come back to Belrive. 100 years, that's extremely exciting. Tell folks what they can expect, because I think we're starting to enter the phase where tickets are available, right?
Well, they are. I mean, go to pgachampionship.com to register. If you haven't registered, it is time to register. And we're just telling everybody to make sure. It is sort of a strange process, but it's the part of the modern day major. And I'm gonna have to find a big road like this somewhere. I don't know where, but we're gonna figure it out now, for sure.
Well, we just wanna spread the word that it is happening, and it is a very, very big deal. And I think Barry Deitch is getting a big taste of St. Louis. Mm-hmm. Today, guys.
Absolutely.
What do you think?
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Matt. Many people will be spending part of their weekend on the golf course. And this gal is Abby Foster. She is the new Miss Illinois. I'm from Illinois, very proud.
And also up is Gateway Motorsports. Coming our way, a street legal two-seater Indy car. Mm-hmm.
Before we get to that, this is Miss Nebraska, though. This is Allison Tietjen. She's 21 years old. We welcome Miss Nebraska to downtown St. Louis. There she is. Gorgeous car. Again, sponsored by Lou Fuse this year. All of those cars.
And she advocates for veterans and active duty military members. Very appropriate for this year's fair. And our theme, of course, is that we salute our troops.
We have a locomotive making its way down Market Street right now, Kent. So many people come together to put together this parade. All the volunteers on floats just like this. All the volunteers with the VP, we appreciate. And then, of course, all the people in the audience right now.
All right, you're watching our coverage of the 135th America's Birthday Parade. And great things are happening is our theme. And great things just continue to happen. And more great things are going to happen, right?
Yeah, absolutely, right after this break.
The 100th PGA Championship heads to Belrive Country Club in 2018. St. Louis's Gateway to the West invites you to be a part of history. Watch more top 100 golfers than any other field compete for the Wanamaker Trophy. Register now on pgachampionship.com/tickets for early access to ticket options.
In a few weeks, the National Urban League Convention will be in St. Louis, and a fantastic new exhibit called Painting for Peace will be featured there. What is your involvement with that?
We're going to bring the largest exhibit of the public art that was done immediately post-Ferguson. And it was just a community coming together that really wasn't reflected in the national media. It's never been put on to this extent. This will be the biggest single public display of this art that's ever happened in St. Louis. So the Painting for Peace exhibit is going to be at the Convention Center during the week-long National Urban League Convention. It's open to the public, and it's going to be curated. So you'll be able to watch videos and see the story of how the art was created. And I would just urge everyone who has an interest to come down and take a look. I don't think you'll regret doing it.
Regions Bank, we are committed to making our customers' banking easier and their lives better.
The 100th PGA Championship heads to Belrive Country Club in 2018. St. Louis's Gateway to the West invites you to be a part of history. Watch more top 100 golfers than any other field compete for the Wanamaker Trophy. Register now on pgachampionship.com/tickets for early access to ticket options.
For over 100 years, the St. Louis Zoo has been recognized worldwide
for conservation efforts, natural habitats,
veterinary sciences, and most of all, animal care.
It's what we do.
But while we're proud of these honors, our biggest reward is this. Healthy, thriving animals, always. It's our promise. The St. Louis Zoo.
We are so happy you are joining your Saturday morning with us live from downtown St. Louis, celebrating the 135th America's Birthday Parade. Our next float that we have is called America's Greatest Idea. And Kent, do you know what that is?
I like to think of it as television weather.
That is a close
really
one. That is second, just behind the National Park System.
Oh, that one.
Mm-hmm. The Gateway Arch, for those of you who don't know, that is a national park, and we are so proud of it. It is just about a mile and a half behind us down Market Street, and the next float represents the America's National Park System. There are 59 of them, and in fact, let's see this performance. I'm pretty excited. Ooh, are you?
I am.
Much fun. That was the Smash Band with Celebration, Kent. I saw people all over dancing, putting their hands together for that. That's what this parade is all about, celebrating, again, the great things that are happening.
Absolutely.
Up next, we have Butterfly Dreams that float. Butterfly Dreams provides events and pageants for differently abled individuals of all ages. They really do fantastic things. They were founded in 2014, already has chapters in Missouri and Illinois. We appreciate the great things that Butterfly Dreams are doing.
You know,
so
what
many
I think
smiling
would be
faces.
What I think would be a great idea to some of our viewers from other parts of the country is look them up, Google them.
Yes.
If you're an activist, and see what they do and how they do it, and model a program or get involved with them and start a chapter maybe locally. They are a fantastic organization.
Cannot agree more. And next up, there's some superheroes, Gateway Guardians. Everyone loves a superhero, Kent. Sometimes I call you Superman.
You call me a lot of things.
I don't
recall you calling
me
Superman.
That's
now.
True. Wonder Woman. Do you ever call me Wonder Woman?
I call you some things.
There we go.
Great power comes with great responsibility, and this is one group of superheroes who will never let us down.
Mm-hmm.
And how
and
about a
they,
super band?
They are leading the Collinsville High School Band from Collinsville, Illinois, directed by Bobby Wright. 122 members. They are playing When Johnny Comes Marching Home.
Band, of course, from Collinsville, Illinois, directed by Bobby Wright, 122 members strong. They return to the parade for the 18th time. Wow, welcome back.
As we've mentioned, all of the high school bands are competing in a contest today. $10,000 is on the line. The Collinsville Kayhawks, 122 members strong, getting in a position.
It takes a while to get 122 of them into position. And again, you'll have to be reminded, this is a high school band, not a college band.
Mm-hmm. That was the Collinsville High School Band performing When Johnny Comes Marching Home.
Our
and
next
who is
balloon,
this guy?
That's Louie the Lightning Bug, sponsored by Ameren, Missouri, glowing brightly in the sky. Even in the daytime, he glows.
He does.
How much power Ameren has. Sponsored by Ameren, Missouri, and manned by volunteers, of course, from Ameren.
Ameren reminds us to conserve energy by turning off lights and unplugging appliances when not in use. And in fact, here in St. Louis, Kent, the weather is so nice, you don't need the air conditioner on.
Well, if you're in the shade, that's true.
Yes.
But it is Midwest and it is summertime, and we got real, real lucky today with perfect summertime, 4th of July weather here in St. Louis.
Louie just guiding along right in front of Union Station downtown, a historic place, Union Station. Just a gem of our city. We appreciate that they let us have that as the backdrop.
Absolutely.
Coming up next is the Gateway Fire Historical Society. They are dedicated to collecting, restoring, preserving, and operating antique fire engines.
They have 6 vintage trucks with them today, and if they could talk,
oh boy,
I bet they have some real stories, right?
Mm-hmm.
Man, oh man. Love those old pieces of equipment, and of course a lot of courageous, heroic firefighters who rode on these trucks over the years, and some of which are probably riding on them today in the parade. We always love our first responders.
We do, here in St. Louis and everywhere across the country, wherever you are tuning in from today, we appreciate it. Coming up next, up Market Street is the Royal Vagabonds, Kent.
Oh, I thought that was the Channel 4 group.
Close.
Royal Vagabonds, get
close.
It? Vagabonds, Channel 4.
You crack yourself up, buddy.
The Royal Vagabonds began in the 1930s as a social club for black professionals and businessmen. And they soon became active in the community, providing services and resources to those in need. And today, the Royal Vagabonds Foundation is dedicated to assisting young people pursue educational advancement. Great group.
This is one of the 17 floats that is riding down Market Street in downtown St. Louis. We have so many incredible charities and organizations in this area, and we appreciate each and every one of them. Just a gorgeous, massive float.
It is.
Smiling faces, so many people happy to be at the 135th America's Birthday Parade. And I think I hear another band.
I think you do. I think what you may hear is the McClure North High School Band. This is a big one. They are from Florissant, Missouri. And they are directed by Jeffrey Sinfer.
80 of those students, they perform America the Beautiful. As they head into the broadcast area, we welcome the kids from McClure North.
So big,
yes.
Yeah. We got two rocket ships, numbers 1 and 2. These are sleek 21st century manned fighter jets that remind us that today's parade is fully protected both on the ground and in the sky as well.
We appreciate that protection.
That's good to know.
Look at them power right through.
I think they're powered by dry ice or something.
Maybe. Could we get a ride in one of those later?
I doubt it.
Oh, yeah, that's true. We don't have much pull here.
We don't.
Who might, though, is this lady. This is Miss Black Missouri USA, Alexis Wells. She is the reigning Miss Black Missouri and is a 26-year-old from New Madrid.
New Madrid.
New Madrid. Thank you very much, Ms. Kent. Alexis advocates for youth empowerment with an emphasis on promoting a healthy body image and lifestyle. You have 2 daughters. I bet you can get behind that platform.
100% behind it. She's beautiful.
She
welcome
is.
Her. Congratulations, Alexis.
More girl power is behind Alexis.
Here we go.
The Girl Scout float is making its way in.
These are the Girl Scouts of Eastern Missouri, the sixth largest Girl Scout council in the nation. They always have a huge contingent here in our parades in St. Louis.
I love Girl Scout cookies, Kenton. When they are dancing and smiling, I like them even more.
Yep.
It's the sixth largest Girl Scout council in the nation. And their mission is to promote young women as girls. I mean that G-I-R-L-S, which stands for go-getters, innovators, risk-takers, and leaders.
That's right.
You over go, girls.
44,000 girls served by 15,000 volunteers in Missouri. We love our Girl Scouts here in the Midwest. You're watching the 135th running of America's Birthday Parade, presented by VP of St. Louis.
Right in downtown St. Louis. Stick with us. We will be back after this break.
New Balance St. Louis, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. New Balance St. Louis, locally owned stores in Richmond Heights, Creve Coeur, and Fairview Heights.
Our kids didn't know they didn't have anything because that's what they've always had. They are not even going to believe what happened over the weekend.
We've been looking for a long time to try to collaborate with the Royal Vagabond. It started with one person from our organization talking to somebody at church who had heard about Zion and their fact that they couldn't build a playground for the 80 kids in their child development center.
It's moments like these that help remind people that we really have a lot more in common than we do separate.
Allen Roofing, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's birthday parade. Allen Roofing, doing your homework and honoring our heroes. aroofing.net.
The freedoms we enjoy are only possible because of the sacrifices made by our military. The Kauffman Fund provides support to St. Louis area veterans and their families who have been deprived of life's basic necessities. We work to bring the entire veterans community together, providing assistance with food, clothing, housing, employment, counseling, dental care, and more. If you're a veteran in need or interested in supporting St. Louis area veterans, visit thekauffmanfund.org.
For over 100 years, the St. Louis Zoo has been recognized worldwide
for conservation efforts, natural habitats,
veterinary sciences, and most of all, animal care.
It's what we do.
But while we're proud of these honors, our biggest reward is this.
Healthy, thriving animals, always. It's our promise. The St. Louis Zoo.
I have a big smile on my face to introduce this next band, O'Fallon Township High School, getting into place. Let's listen to the Panthers.
Wow, Huh?
Returning for their 23rd year in Kent, I have received emails and Facebook messages from parents and grandparents of those performers. O'Fallon Township High School in O'Fallon, Illinois. Moms, grandmas, dads, grandpas.
There you go.
We hope you enjoyed it. Matt, I know you enjoyed it. You had a front row seat for that performance. And in fact, you're with some of the performers of this parade.
Yes, I want to draw some attention to that because let me tell you, whether it's a band or a musical number, these things don't happen by accident. It takes a lot of preparation time, and a lot of the singing and dancing routines you're seeing, the people involved in those rush out and they're participating in multiple entries as they pass by, like this young lady. What's your name?
My name's Sydney Evenson.
And how many performances are you involved with in the parade today?
I'm in four today.
Isn't that difficult? Because there's full wardrobe changes for each one, right?
Yeah.
How long did you have to practice and rehearse for this?
It's been about a month or two.
How long have you been dancing?
Well, I started dancing when I was in preschool, so.
And she's got to go. She's literally being beckoned behind her back. Let me show you what happens. There's wardrobe. There's a tent here. This is where the ladies go in and change between all the performances. It really is a tightly orchestrated machine down here, guys. In fact, they're going right now.
And kids, there are more than 300 performers in this year's parade, ages 7 to 70. All fantastic, like we just saw Sydney right there.
Absolutely. And we appreciate their time and their effort because they put a lot into it every year. Man, that's a big... Very, very exciting. All right, let's talk. Reading is great.
Absolutely. The next performance float as they get started. This is the Seuss the Musical Float, and they are providing inspiration for the song, Oh, the Things You Can Think. I don't mean to be biased, Kent, but I think that's my favorite one that we have seen. I love that.
And I love the theme of reading is great because all of us, that's usually one of the first books that we'll read is a Dr. Seuss book, and they always have a great performance, too, here.
That was.
That's awesome.
Very good stuff. And coming up next, we have the Moolah Air Patrol. It is an actual airplane fuselage customized into a float.
Very cool. This is one of 28 units of the St. Louis Moolah Temple that they use for the enjoyment of the patients and families at world-famous Shriners Hospital for Children. They never turn away a patient here, and they have done so much good in this community over such a long time, as long as I can remember, and that's a long, long time.
And Kent, just not our community. There are Shriners all over the country. Many of you are joining us from all different parts of this great country. We appreciate that and the good work that Shriners is doing. Oh my goodness, we have a shark, Kent, on Market Street.
Never
should I
a good
be worried?
Sign. We just talked about this on Channel 4.
That, sharks?
I don't know. Sharks in the Mississippi.
In the Mississippi. Well, they have made their way to Market Street because things are picking up, which reminds us recycling is a great way to protect the planet and turn old things into new ones again.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
The parade designers have even recycled an old-time technique for painting the eyes of parade characters, so that's good.
This gal doesn't need any help with her eyes. Jennifer Snyder, Miss Missouri USA. We are happy that she is here. And in fact, while attending college, she spent summers volunteering at the VA hospital, logging more than 900 hours working with veterans, working to overcome PTSD. Jennifer, we salute you.
Absolutely.
Veterans, we salute all of you. And to all of the veterans' families who are watching, too, thank you for your sacrifice for our country.
And there you saw the Hispanic Festival, and they are here to remind us of the Hispanic influence, history, and heritage in America. Colorfully costumed riders down there, as you can see.
They are representing Hispanic countries like Mexico, Bolivia, Argentina, and Spain. And as they wheel right through the broadcast box right behind them, hot on their tails, Kent, the Normandy High School Band. Normandy is in North St. Louis County in Missouri. And soon you will see them. They are directed by Bernard Long as the Hispanic Festival cars make their way through.
Boy, and they got some great
Ooh,
cars.
Ooh, look at that one. You'd look nice cruising in that.
I think I would. I really do.
I'll put a word into the boss.
Go down to Venezuela and take a cruise in a yellow vet.
Yeah, I'll go to Bolivia. Ride in that. This is so fun to watch. So many smiling faces. They have their waves down, their official parade wave.
You think they practice their waves?
Oh, they absolutely do. Looks like a fire truck is making its way up.
And in the background there, that's the volunteer fire department that you're looking at. The Backstoppers, mm-hmm. of course, a great group here in St. Louis that provides support to the families of fallen officers and first responders here in the St. Louis area. And we love the Backstoppers organization, getting bigger and better every year. Unfortunately, we need them, and they do a great service here in our community.
Here is the Normandy High School Band. As I was talking about, this is really fantastic, Kent. It was the very first high school band to march in this parade way back in 1958.
Wow.
They're being led by Bernard Long.
Doesn't have to be a big band to make a lot of good music.
Absolutely.
All right, once again, that is the Normandy High School Band as Bernard Long Jr. Conducts his orchestra there. They placed first at the Liberty Bowl last year. Well, good for them.
Absolutely.
You are watching the 135th America's Birthday Parade. Great things are happening across our country, and today they're happening here in St. Louis, this parade presented by VP of St. Louis.
Stick with us. We'll be back after this short break.
Honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's Birthday Parade, Randall's Wines and Spirits, now delivering downtown, Central West End, and Clayton. Shop Randalls.com.
Why is Region so committed to making St. Louis a better place?
It's one of the biggest holidays of the year, and we just view it as a celebration of our community, and it's great to be part of it, and we're happy to partner with KMOB.
You don't just do big events like this.
Corporate values are to make our community stronger. Well, we've got about 500 associates. We give all the associates a day off, a day of caring to do what they want. We also organize team-based, not-for-profit volunteer activities. And I see it as something that we should never stop doing.
I've been a proud and loyal Regions customer for about 7 years now, is because I knew no matter what I was doing, where I was going, there would be a bank close to me.
St. Louis is one of our growth markets. It's been identified for the company as a growth market. And over the next several years, we'll be spending tens of millions of dollars on branches. No matter what happens in your life, you're going to need someone to help you with your finances. Very few people can go it alone.
Med Exchange, honoring our hometown heroes and supporting America's Birthday Parade. Med Exchange, providing and servicing medical equipment in the St. Louis metro areas and honoring our hometown heroes. MedExchangeSTL.com.
My name is Major Mike Roberts. I am with the Missouri Army National Guard, and I'm a brigade training officer with 70th Troop Command. I choose to serve because it's being a member of a team that does such significant work. I'd like to say hello to my mom and dad and my family and friends in the St. Louis area, particularly my wife and my three kids.
Salute the Troops is brought to you by Lakeside Exteriors, thanking those who serve for protecting all the places we call home.
Welcome back to America's Birthday Parade, coming to you from St. Louis, presented by VP of St. Louis. And I have to tell you, we love our music, we love our blues, and we love our jazz here in St. Louis. And our next group is the Reunion Jazz on the Levee, and that is sponsored by UHY Advisors. We're going to give a listen to a performance from this group. Ooh, that sounds good.
Down by the riverside, the Showboat. Job what? By the Phil that Woodmore Singers, accompanied by the Reunion Jazz Band. I saw a lot of smiles, Kent.
I got goosebumps on that one. That was fantastic.
We were
both
swaying back and forth in our chairs. It's
another great local group is the Wings of Hope. That's our next inflatable that's volunteered by folks from Wings of Hope, whose mission is to provide medical care, education, and hands-on guidance for sustainable projects in more than 40 countries. Wings of Hope is the only free air ambulance referral service in the Midwest, and was a 2011 Nobel Peace Prize nominee. Fantastic organization.
Absolutely.
Look them up and learn about them.
And coming up next, the University of Missouri Golden Girls bring some sparkle to downtown St. Louis. Kent, one of the first things I ever heard about Mizzou was the Golden Girls.
Yep.
I was very young when my mom told me about them. They are absolutely fantastic. They delight sports fans all around the company, the country, as they accompany the Marching Mizzou Band. Look at their smiles, their fancy outfits. They make
America's they are Golden Girls. Look
birthday parade sparkle.
There's a Chris Craft boat. That's a very well-known manufacturer of boats. Iconic Chris Craft, the symbol of American recreational boating, from a company with a history dating back to the early 1860s. During the 1940s, Chris Craft switched to wartime production and created 12,000 military vessels.
Smiling right there is Katie Moeller. She is the Miss Fleur de Lis 2017. And this gal is busy, Kent. She could be gunning for our job. She is a TV anchor at KRCG in New Bloomfield, Missouri. Welcome to her, and welcome to the Breeze Modern Day Band from Breeze, Illinois. They're playing the Modern Day Victory March. 65 members, directed by Blake Cordy.
This is their 11th appearance in the VP of America's Birthday Parade. The band's 65 members. Strong. Performing in front of Union Station here in downtown St. Louis.
Up next, we have the American Red Cross, the truck, and the blood mobile all across the country, Kent. The Red Cross does such amazing things. Many different communities have blood drives. We appreciate all the volunteers of the Red Cross and the fantastic work that they do. The Red Cross collects more than 40% of America's blood supply.
Always there when we need them.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's the first thing you hear when there's a fire or a flood or whatever else.
The Red Cross is there
providing support. What would we be without them?
Right after that, we have the circus coming to town. You see them making their way down Market Street. I love the American flag blowing in the breeze on Market Street. We appreciate our firefighters for putting that up. Here we go. The circus comes to town. Watch out for some unusual action as it passes in front of our cameras. I'm kind of nervous, not sure what to expect with them.
Yeah, I always used to put my fingers in my ears with the circus because I was afraid they were going to shoot the guy out of the cannon.
You're also afraid they were going to shoot you out of the cannon.
Well, they probably should have.
Sometimes we think about doing
that. Oh, they're all clad in red, white, and blue for America's birthday. The performers on this float have their own way of celebrating our independence with some crazy antics.
As they make their way into the broadcast box, we will let you watch them as we head to another break. You are watching the 135th America's Birthday Parade in downtown St. Louis.
The BP Parade is a St. Louis tradition, and I also feel that Weber Chevrolet is also. BP Parade's been around a little bit longer than us. We've only been around 115 years, but they're both in there, and you know, people have been around town for a while, have seen our commercials, have bought cars from us, and of course they come to the parade. So I like being traditional, and I think we like really, really, really like supporting the local things that give people fun things to do. So being part of the parade, supporting the parade, sponsoring the parade, it's a no-brainer for us. Great things are definitely happening at Weber. We have maybe, I think, almost 60 more employees this year than last year. Our sales are up. Chevrolet is making great product and we're supporting it. We're expanding our facilities. We're getting more and more features and benefits for our customers. It's a very, very exciting time to be selling Chevrolets in St. Louis. So I can tell you right now, great things are happening at Weber Chevrolet. From all of us at Weber Chevrolet, have a safe and happy Independence Day.
There's a super fun city, a quick getaway, where there's so much excitement you need more than a day. St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family, infinity plus a ton. It's got works of wonder, things to wow your brain, an amazing pet performance all aboard on the train. Some museums are historic, some hit the right blues notes, maybe catch a cards game, whatever paddles your boat. Yes, St. Louis is the stop for nonstop fun, so much fun for your family, infinity plus a ton.
For over 100 years, the St. Louis Zoo has been recognized worldwide
for conservation efforts, natural habitats,
veterinary sciences, and most of all, animal care.
It's what we do. But while we're proud of these honors, our biggest reward is this. Healthy, thriving animals, always. It's our promise. The St. Louis Zoo.
From all the smiles and the waves that you are seeing on Market Street, you can tell this is a great day in St. Louis. In fact, the Great Things Are Happening float has just made its way into the heart of this area. They are going to perform with Uncle Sam and 50 of his talented supporters. They are going to do Yankee Doodle Dandy, a country favorite, I would say, for
Absolutely.
All Americans out there.
Perfect for the 4th of July mm-hmm. and Independence Day. Let's give a listen.
Yankee Doodle.
can't get much more patriotic than that. Great things are happening, Yankee Doodle Dandy. Fantastic job by the performers, Kent. Many of them have performed up to 10 times already today.
I can't help but laugh because the quality of the performances in the parade this year, the 135th America's Birthday Parade, coming to you from St. Louis, Missouri. And next up is our St. Louis County Parks and Recreation Foundation float. And you can see that there. There's something for everyone at the 73 St. Louis County Parks, from carousel rides, kayaking, contemporary art, and a world famous sculpture park as well. All available here in St. Louis County. We love our parks
we
in St. Louis.
And
have a lot of good ones on the east side too. Mm-hmm. A lot of parks in our area.
Coming up next, the Lakeside Lutheran High School Band. They're from the great state of Wisconsin. It's a multi-award winning band. 100 members made their way south to St. Louis. And they are under the direction of Glenn Pufall. This is their sixth year in this parade.
They have 100 members.
And every high school band, Kent, is part of a competition today. $10,000 is on the line as we take a listen.
You know, we talked about the competition, and think about a band, 100 members strong, and all of the volunteers and staff and instruments and everything else that have to make their way
from
Wisconsin. So that's why that money is so important. This is the Discover Expedition of St. Charles float that you're looking at right now.
It is dedicated to preserving the legacy of explorers Lewis and Clark. Its members bring the past to life through discussions and living history demonstrations. St. Charles County, just outside St. Louis County. Yeah, love this.
For those of you who aren't geographically aware of where we are here in the middle of the country, we have three big rivers that come together here. The Missouri, the Mississippi, and the Illinois all have a confluence here. So very important trade routes back in the early days of the settling of this country of ours, and appropriately enough, we have a big 4th of July celebration.
We do. We're so proud of our heritage here, and we're also so proud of the Moolah Shrine Motor Patrol as they make their way down Market Street. We have talked about the Moolah Shrine and the Shriners a few times. The red fezes, Kent, you can't miss them.
That's their hats.
Yes. They're in their mini cars. They're very familiar. They're a favorite sight each and every year at this parade. And they really are followed by some pretty wonderful antique vehicles. We just saw some of them right there.
You know, we've been talking a lot about this parade, and we would say to all of you that are around the country, if you ever have an opportunity, the parade is followed by a 2 or 3 day fair that has world-class performances and a wonderful fair. And we hope that you can maybe join us here in St. Louis some
year
for the
yeah.
parade and the fair, and be sure and stop by the booth and say hi as well. But this parade is not over. We have an unbelievable finale set up for you here.
And it is sponsored by Downtown STL Inc. Very excited about this one. Great things are happening in downtowns all across America, including ours here in St. Louis. And to close our show, we are going to take you to this performance of America the Beautiful.
for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesty above the fruited plain.
There is a reason that America the Beautiful is the finale of America's birthday parade, the 135th edition of our parade. We hope you had as much fun as we did and enjoyed experiencing this fantastic parade from downtown St. Louis. I am Laura Hediger.
And I'm Kent Earhart. And one thing we know for sure, this is a great country, a land of opportunity, and great things really are happening. And one of those great things will be the 136th America's Birthday Parade, and we hope we see you here in St. Louis next year. Happy 4th of July, everyone.